We're now three episodes in The Bad Batch, and I feel like this has been my favorite episode of the three so far. So we're going to be getting into full spoilers for this episode, so make sure you've seen the episode if you would like to before continuing with this review. In Replacements, we get our first real look at what Crosshair's been up to since he split off from the rest of the Bad Batch. For the Bad Batch themselves, their plot this episode is relatively simple. They are stuck on a moon and they have to make repairs to their ship. It's very reminiscent of the scenes on the asteroid in episode 5. Instead of a space slug though, the Bad Batch is dealing with an Ordo Moon Dragon, so a much smaller, much cuter creature than the space slugs. Despite doing something that I normally don't love in Star Wars, where they kind of recreate one of the original trilogy scenes, I think it works out really well here, and we do get a lot more building the relationship between Omega, Hunter, and Wrecker. Hunter is clearly settling into his role as kind of a father figure or a guardian for Omega, and this episode builds up more on the Omega and Wrecker side, where we kind of see Wrecker get into a similar situation, where beyond just learning or caring about Omega's physical safety, we start to see more of an emotional connection, and he works on a room for Omega within the ship. One of my concerns coming into the series was that Wrecker was just kind of going to be this one-dimensional, purely combat-focused character, but in this episode we see him get through without actually engaging in any combat at all and still contributing something to the episode. But this does kind of highlight something that I felt has been a bit of a weakness of the show so far, which is that Echo and Tech are actually not really fleshed out that well, or not really as involved in anything yet. Usually there's some main plot going on, and then Echo and Tech have kind of just been in the background. They might need to get something done at some point, but they don't really engage with any of the other characters that much. We get a few moments between Wrecker and Tech in some of the other episodes, but that's not here either. I assume with both characters this will come eventually, and with Echo it's not a huge deal because we do have kind of more backstory for him, he's shown up in more stuff, so it is good to give some of the newer characters a bit of room to breathe, especially with their introduction in the Clone Wars Season 7 arc being a little too tropey. So I'm hoping we do get more of Tech development over the next little while, and I'm sure we will. It's just something that I feel has been lacking so far. The Crosshair side of the episode is where we get a bit more of the development and even some of the world building that I think is the better part of this episode. Especially since bringing Crosshair back into the fold or addressing him in some way, even if it's not reconciling with him, does seem to be the main plot of Season 1, or what we're going to be getting into eventually. We're continuing on with the subplot of the Empire looking into other sources for soldiers, why they're running this program off of Kamino, I'm not 100% sure, but Tarkin is still on Kamino, and he's joined by Vice Admiral Rampart, who we saw briefly last episode. Rampart has put together a team of four soldiers that Crosshair's put in charge of, and they're given the same mission that Bad Batch originally was, to hunt down Saw Gerrera's group on Onderon. And we actually get non-clone troopers wearing clone trooper armor, which I thought was pretty cool. And one of these elite soldiers talks about how the Empire has given them a purpose and has kind of provided for them in a way the Republic never has. So we do get a bit of how some of the Imperial Army could have been brought into the Empire, and how some of the inhabitants of the galaxy could have become early sympathizers of the Empire. But we get the flip side of this later, where as soon as that same soldier is no longer willing to comply with what the Empire wants and to kill the civilians that are living with Saw Gerrera's militants, he objects and he gets executed by Crosshair. I really do hope that this isn't just resolved by removing Crosshair's chip and then suddenly he's back on the good side, because there are some of things of what he's doing that, while they may be influenced by the inhibitor chip, clearly line up with what he wants to do and what his values are. So I think if we just get redemption through removing the chip, we are probably going to miss out on what could be a more interesting story, and that's my biggest fear with Bad Batch right now, that we will miss out on that. I'm hoping they don't go that direction. On the Bad Batch slash Omega side again, we actually do see Omega more able to contribute to the group in this episode. In the last two episodes, while she's generally been able to provide some useful information, she's generally been trying to help out and then ends up getting in the way or requiring rescue. And in this episode, she does manage to get the part that they need for the ship back, largely on her own. She helps Hunter not die when he gets his mask knocked off. So she is slowly coming into her own within the group, and they're slowly starting to accept her as one of their own. So I am liking how the development is going in that direction, and that's something that I've been really enjoying about these episodes. We are starting to get more hints at the strife or the conflict between the Kaminoans and the Galactic Empire. It doesn't look like we're going to be going the route of the full-on Kamino Rebellion like we got in Battlefront 2, the original one, but it does seem like they are trying to prove their value to the Empire, and that's probably not going to go well for them. We know that generally will fall through long-term, so we'll have to see how the Kaminoans respond to that. Which I wasn't really expecting to get coming into the series, or really at any point. We generally just see Kamino either take up arms against the Empire or kind of fall into the background. So it is going to be interesting to see what develops in that area as well. Either way, hope you're all enjoying the Bad Batch. Those are my thoughts for Episode 3. We're going to keep doing these reviews on Fridays, and the episode reviews for TapCaf Transmissions with Eckhart Slatter, we're probably going to be moving those to Friday nights, though that would be the first time next week, not tonight. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you next time. Bye, everyone.